Have you ever wondered how infinite scrolling works and how to implement it yourself on your projects or websites? Well, the way it usually works is that when you scroll down until the last item enters the viewport, it ends up invoking a function that is responsible for fetching the next page data. Once fetched, the data gets appended to the rest so the user can continue scrolling, and the process repeats until all the pages are exhausted. It all happens in a split second, so the user gets the illusion of scrolling the content infinitely. So now the question becomes, how do we check if the user has reached the last item on the page? Well, the most effective way is by using the intersection observer. It's a browser API that allows you to observe the positional changes of an element relative to its parent or the viewport. You create an observer and provide it with a callback function that will be triggered depending on your use case, which in our case is when the element enters the viewport, then specify which element you want it to observe. Now enough talking, let's start building it. We'll make it into a custom hook so that we can just plug and play it anywhere. I'm using TypeScript here, ignore the type definitions if you're not familiar with it. It will observe an HTML element of type T and accept the callback and a dependency list that will be used to control and reset the observer. For example, when new data is fetched, it would then observe the last element, or when all the pages are fetched, it would prevent the callback from firing. We need to store the observer in a ref so it won't reset itself upon re-renders, and create the element or node reference with useCallback for the same reason. It will be memoized until any of the dependency changes or the callback changes. It should only proceed when every dependency is true. Disconnect the previous observer and initialize a new one. It will give you the elements it is currently observing. Since we'll only be observing a single one, check if it's intersecting with the viewport and fire the callback. And make it observe the node. Finally, return the reference so that we can attach it to our desired element. Now we'll first use it with plain old fetch API, then we'll jump to React query. We have the usual states here. The loading spinner and the products list that we'll fetch in a second will go here. Let's start with the fetch function. We'll paginate the data using the skip and limit method. I will be using the dummy JSON API to fetch products with pagination. The response looks like this. It will include the skip and limit we passed, the total number of products available, and the list of products itself. This way we can check if we have fetched all of them, meaning we no longer have a next page. And simply return products. We want to run this on mount and set the products on success or handle any errors here. That should be enough to list the products. I think it fetched all of them at once. Let's assign a default limit of 10. Now it only fetches 10 products per page. And now it's time for the infinite scroll magic. Pass in the callback to fetch the next page. Let us skip the number of products we currently have. And then merge the new products with the previous ones. It should only be triggered when we have a next page available and we are not already loading a page. All that's left is to attach the ref to the very last product. Always access the mapped array this way. It will accurately represent the array you are getting after any filters or other pure methods you may be applying before it. And simply check if it's the last product and give it the ref. Now the moment of truth. And it all worked out nicely. Now let's move over to the React query way of doing this. It will use most of the code we have here. I'll change the example to React query. We don't need these states anymore. Instead of just products, return the complete response. And the useEffect is going to. We'll utilize the infinite query hook that comes with React query. It'll need the key, a query function. And we have to tell it how to get the next page param. Using the last page, create the cursor from its skip and limit parameter that, if you recall, we receive for each page. And return the cursor only if we have more products to fetch. Now we can access this in the query function and pass it to our fetch call. Since we are getting the whole response, we might want to select what we specifically want. For each page, we only want the products. Let's comment this out. We'll get back to it. First, check if the query works. It will provide the products in an array of pages that will merge into a single array using the flat method. It will display the first 10 products as it should. Let's get back to our observer. It will be much simpler this time. Just call the fetchNextPage method. And as for the dependency, use the hasNextPage property. Don't forget the loading state. And it's basically done. I think it should be fetching, not loading. isLoading is only true for the initial fetch, while isFetching is true for the initial as well as every subsequent fetch. And that should wrap up this video. We've covered the intersection observer API by building our own custom hook out of it and handling pagination for infinite scroll with just plain fetch API and with infinite query from the React query library. If you've learned something, do let me know by pressing the like button and subscribe for more content like this.